all in the numbers. Number one, that's terror. Number two, that's terror.
Why contain it? It's cool.
Yo, hello everybody. Uh-oh, I'm already busted. It's gonna be one of those nights, I see. Welcome in. I'm a slightly broken DigiDoggi. Let's bonk me back into shape and give me some less infinite head pats here. Hello, hello everybody. I hope you're doing well tonight. How's it going? How's it been? I'm your favorite dog-shaped robot quirky girl, DigiDoggi. And I'm back from Japan. I have been absolutely just mollywomped by jet lag this week. I apologize for missing out on my stream yesterday as well. We had a little boot looping issue with my streaming laptop, which was super not doggers. But I got it sorted out, I think. Yes, I see Ash has noticed that we have our lovely, in quotation marks, stream pet Crud back. He lives once more, for better or for worse. And I'm so happy to have you here tonight, guys. Thank you so much for being here. Let me see. Let me get my dynamic issues working here. Sometimes this needs a little kick and it should start working better. Hello? There we go. All right. So yes, we have Crud, our little stream pet, our funny raccoon. He is back. We're having some server issues with Twitch.tv, so buckle up for that. Thank you for bearing with me if we get disconnected. And I really want to thank everybody. Oh my goodness, you guys got busy with a hype train while I was getting ready. Oh wow. Thank you so very much to Twin White Tiger. Thank you for 7 months of support. Konnichiwa right back at ya. I guess it's right on the border between Konnichiwa and Konbanwa right now. Hi DoomGuy7419, it is a doggy once again. Thank you for 11 months of support. CoolGames17, thank you for that gift sub. And thank you so much for that hype train. Thank you for the bits, Twin White Tiger. And, wow. Yes, thank you Nitrim for the resub. Thank you to Saki V. Oh my goodness, you guys found the doggy dance emote. I'm super pleased with this one. It's super, super cute. And oh my goodness, I already need a sippy. How are y'all doing? How you been? I have been just absolutely not adjusting well to being back in the States, honestly. My sleep schedule is non-existent, but I'm doing my best, and I got some cool video edited for you guys today. So once we're all settled in a little bit, we'll go to KABUKICHO, which is the real-life inspiration for Yakuza's KABUKICHO. But let's just take it easy. Let's chill. Hello. Let me catch up with chat. Oh my goodness, we have so many doggy dances. Ah. Oh, chat. I have been working on some stuff with Pine Tree Noodle. I'm actually a little later than scheduled tonight because Pine Tree Noodle was here. She was here. And she and I would be... Oh! Yo, it's a raid from Meryl Vixenberg. Oh my goodness. Wait. Raidvirus.exe. Meryl, you're one of my mods. You really should... Oh my goodness. We're never going to stop getting these raidvirus.exe, are we? Oh well, here we go. Yo, Meryl Vixenberg, thank you so much for that raid. I'm DigiDoggi, your favorite dog-shaped robot corgi girl. We're going to be talking about my trip to Japan tonight, and I really appreciate you stopping in. Meryl is a longtime friend of the stream. She's been here with us for over a year now. Thank you, Meryl, for joining us that one fun evening with Metal Gear Solid 2. That was a really good time. I hope you had fun with your stream. What were you getting up to tonight? Let me beepily boop here and get you a shout-out. You should definitely go follow Meryl Vixenberg. She's a new PNG tuber, and she's having fun figuring out the whole Twitch thing. You were trying out Prey. Oh, I heard that one's really good. How was it? Did you have fun? Here, let me get. That's the wrong one. We want this. Come on, don't be shy. What? What the heck? There it is. Okay. Whoa, that's loud. Sorry, I have got a bunch of new music in here and some of it is not quite normalized, I guess. We'll figure it out as we go. But either way, I'm glad that you had fun, Meryl.
Just look at that.
Sir? Sir, this is my Gerwalk. You need to get out of- You don't have clearance. Go! That's right. Yeah, you get out of here. Oh my goodness, it feels like it's been forever since we did this.
Freezing.
I am so sorry, chat. I really meant to just go hot and heavy into getting back into things. But it just hasn't been working out that way. It turns out... So, I drastically underestimated the amount of jet lag that I would be experiencing.
We're in for some chop.
Wow, I think that was the dropship. Thanks for that Moai there, Hell. How am I doing, Nova? I am whelmed. I am whelmed. Oh gosh, you know, chat, I actually... So, eto is just in Japanese. And eto, like, got a lot of use for me when I was in Japan. I don't know what it is, but since I landed back in America, it feels like... Most of the Japanese just dropped out of my head. I've gotten like full dummy Richie mode. Also, I guess that's really annoying. So this doesn't work unless I'm focused in on Binyan right now. I'm gonna have to do some fixing on some things. But yeah, that was Richie ears, not devil ears specifically. Now the devil ears would be like this. My Japanese is not great, but I did just enough to get through my Japan trip. But there was definitely a lot of just like trying to stall a little bit, trying to remember the right word. Thankfully people are super, super friendly and patient if they see that you're making the effort. Otherwise, I would have probably gotten yelled at. But thank you. Oh, we love DigiDoggi. Thank you, Meryl. Oh my goodness. Thank you for being here though, guys. Oh my goodness, I'm about to burp. Excuse me. Yes. So, I have a lot of footage that I'm still slowly going through. I have run up against a problem this week that it took me a while to deal with, honestly. Also, why is the music so loud? Oh my goodness. Is it super loud for you guys too? Or is this just a doggy problem? I feel like I am overwhelming myself with the music. Even if it is really good music. But yes, for everybody who wasn't here last week, I just crash landed from Tokyo a couple weeks ago. I am still shaking off the jet lag. It turns out that jet lag actually goes for about 1 to 1.5 days per time zone that you cross, and I crossed 18 of them. So we're coming in on 2 weeks since I just got back. We are hopefully on the tail end of me being a dummy doggy, but oh my goodness, it's been a ride, chat. Every time I think I've fixed my sleep schedule, it is right back to like falling asleep at, I don't know, like 5 p.m. and then waking up at 11. And then it's like, well, crap, there goes my whole night. So... it's not been as productive as I was hoping, but I do have a KABUKICHO video. Better than being a DigiDoggi. Oh my god, you have no idea. I have so much of that. I have so many stream friends that I'll go and visit, and even if I follow them for a while and like they've been in my stream, I'll get a hi DigiDoggi, and it's like, oh.
Old man, warning. Oh. Warning.
Warning! Warning! I am not a DigiDoggi. I am a DigiDoggi. That's right. A DigiDoggi. Perfect timing, Tex. Yeah, hi! Hi, TexMaxDD. How you doing? How you been? Ooh, we got me in glitch mode. Ooh, that's fun now. I have the extra gimmicky redeem set up. The snoot is sniffing and it's adorable. Yeah, it's extra sniffly and that's good too because, oh my goodness, the allergy season, you guys. I am completely fried. I came back and there was a different biome, basically. I left and things were all cold and rainy and dead, and now things are all warm and springy and polleny. I'm like, that's great, but also, oh my god, I'm so sniffly. Just give me a good spain and spain out all the snot. But hi, Myati258, how you doing? How you been? Oh, give me the slime. Yes. Yellow death pollen coating your car, giving you migraines. Yeah, I actually have a light headache right now. Oh, chat. It's not done yet. It's coming really soon. But, oh, let me see, actually. Can I? Let me see if I can do this. Ooh, we got the good jams. Let me pull this up really quickly here, since this slideshow... You know what? We'll start with this slideshow, actually. You're good. How is Freya? I'm tired, and there's allergies, and there's technical difficulties, but we're gonna do our best. We're gonna have fun. Low poly DigiDoggi. Oh, Nova? You know, I would love to do that for you, but I think for tonight, I'm actually going to refund your points there on the select your doggy, and I'm gonna temporarily disable that one for now. For now. No hard feelings. I've just got something cooking, and I need to prepare. So thank you for your thank you for your redeem, but also wait until next week. That's all I'm gonna say. Let's see. Yeah, I'm so sorry about that though. Let me go in the rewards request queue here. Actually, wait, mods? Is anybody available? Would really appreciate the backup to do that for Nova, but I understand if you're not. What the heck? We got requests in here from 4 months ago. Okay, yeah, there's your points back there, Nova. Sorry. But also tune in next week, we got something cool. Oh. Is it a Friday once again? You know what? Sure, it's a Friday once again. Thank you, David Lynch. It's been a while since I heard that. Imagine if the ATM just shot your money back out at you after you put it in. Imagine if it did that, but you also got the money in your bank account balance anyway. That would be pretty dope. It's only a day late. Wait. Yeah, if I was still in Japan, it would be Friday somewhere. Oh, I'm gonna have to mute myself and have a lot of weird, awkward pauses this time, chat. Because I got the sniffles, and I gotta mute myself every time I sniffle. Which is a lot, actually. So, my deepest apologies. Understandable and alright then. No need to apologize it as you completely understand it. Yeah, we got gimmicks cooking, I'll put it that way. So tune in for next week's Mega Man Legends 2 stream and woof, find out. But let's see here. Let's start with the slideshow, actually. Cause I can't figure out how to put these in a video. I don't know what to do. So jeez. Super sore throat. My goodness. Yeah, this is Super Potato in Akihabara. Hey, Pine Tree Noodle, glad you made it safely. So Super Potato is one of the most famous and long-lived game stores in Akihabara. And wait, this is just Akihabara now. But yes, hi Pine Tree, hello. Yeah, we're gonna start off with some slides really quick. Oh my goodness. Oh god, I'm so sniffly. Hold on, I'm just gonna blow my nose.
Ah, my goodness.
Yeah, that's right, that's what I said. Ah, I should have run that antivirus software before I booted up today. If there were multiple PTNs, would it be Pine Trees Noodle or Pine Tree Noodles? Pine Trees Noodle, I believe. Also, I just did the thing where you blow your nose and now you can't, hear? That's fun. That's fun. That's not bad or frustrating or upsetting. So, give me a second. Actually, I'm sorry. Oh, we got the badass music now. Oh my goodness. Okay, you know what? That's a sign. We're just gonna get right to it. I want to show you guys the KABUKICHO video. Let's see. Well, should I hold off on that a little bit? I want to make sure everybody's here first. Hi, Connor. Hello. How's it going? Isn't that our breaks-in friend? Hello. Hope you're doing well. I got a Who card when I was in Japan there, Connor. Let me see if I can, so the OBS's slideshow function is doofus dumb. And it
Am
can
I
only,
glad he's frozen in there and that we're out here.
Whoa.
And that he's Michelle.
The caveman.
And that we're frozen out here. And that we're in there. And I just remembered we're out here. What I want to know is where's the caveman?
Where is the caveman? Apparently OBS's built-in slideshow thingy is broken and dumb and can only display 7 images at once. So let's try it with a different set of images now. That is still the same set of images. Come on, OBS, get it together. Let's try a different set of images. I said. Okay, more super potato images. Let's start with that. We can only do 7 at a time, dang it. That's silly. Oh, this fox is in great shape. My local game store, Pink Gorilla, has one of these, but it's been stolen multiple times and it's all beat up and stuff. So it was good to see one in such lovely shape. This was a little Game Center CX shrine, almost. They had like a little display and they had like drawings of Arino-san in there and things were autographed. It was cool.
Affirmative.
That's right, SCV driver. They had really cool accessories for super cheap. I wanted to take home everything, but they were too bulky. Oh, it was Mappy. Yeah, this game store is Super Potato. It's really cool to visit, but I would say, chat, if you go to Akihabara, don't buy the game stuff there unless you're just not going to any other game stores the whole time, because they mark them up like crazy there. What you should do instead is go to Surugaya in Yokohama. Oh, I just really like these drawings. This was all super cute. They had so many CRTs going in that space. You couldn't go to any corner of the room without getting blasted by radiation. It was a good time to be had by all. But yeah, let me load more files into this thing. We're just gonna have to do it manually. It's great. Let's see, Oh yes, more pictures of Super Potato, including some very important ones. God, I love being blasted by radiation. That's the spirit, Nitrum. This little guy was just on the shelving units. I love him. I love you, little guy. Look at him. He's so good. They had the gold Rockman 4 part at one point. Oh yeah, wow. Dang, I would have loved to have seen that. They had a signed PlayStation from, it was signed by Yoji Shinkawa and Hideo Kojima. Oh yeah, these little drawings, I just got a good close-up of them. I love them. I love that little Zero in Metool. Bork, 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 bork. Yeah, speaking of Rockman stuff, they just had tons of it. It was good to see. But the prices? Oh my god. The super potato prices are just outrageous. It is definitely going to make your wallet super hurt. But I almost bought a shirt anyway. Oh, we looped around to the little guy. Let's load more into the image hopper here. Oh, chat! They had somebody special for sale. Let's see. I don't know if this loads first or last, so let me, Thanks, Tex. Let's see. Oh, I want to make sure I don't miss any of these cool ones that I'm trying to show you guys. It's really hard to do when OBS is being a buy-it. Is the dollar to yen rate still about 100 to 1? Oh no, Moonstorm. It's about 66 yen to every... Wait. I screwed that up. 100 yen... No. Sorry, a dollar is worth about 133 yen, basically. 66.6 yen to a dollar. No, that's not correct. I'll put it this way. 100 yen... Oh, wait. No. Okay, so the way you phrase this makes it sound different. But yes, you're right, Skeletor. So, one 100 yen is 66 US cents right now. So yeah, their economy isn't doing the best, but it made it really cheap for me to eat. I'll put it that way. It was good eats. I very much enjoyed that. I should have gotten more like traditional Japanese tourist food, but honestly, I only had eyes for the good ramen that I was getting and a bunch of the various different fast food places that I was trying because I was so curious. They were all good, by the way. All the food was good. There was no bad food. Even Denny's. But yeah, Japan is on the verge of a recession. Although the tourism dollars have got to be helping with that. And let's see. I want to make sure we get him. Got to get him into this slideshow. Yeah, Rich is for sale at Super Potato. Why is Richie Koopo for sale? What the heck? What the fuck, Koopo? No, like, for reals, though, like...
What the fuck, Koopo?
Like, that's so weird, but yeah, no, he's apparently the protagonist of a new Dreamcast game. Shut up! They had Tamagotchi stuff on the walls. They had Dio on a candy cabinet.
Kono Dio da!
And he was looking good, honestly. Looking fine. They had one of these crazy Game Boy kiosks that I haven't seen since I was little. They had... Wait. Oh, do I have it? Oh, damn, I don't have it in here. Let me see if I can load it. But look, that's Rich. That's definitely Rich. That is definitely Rich.
How interesting.
No, sir, you don't have your passport. You need to get back to the hotel before a Japanese police officer catches you. That's right! It's dangerous! It's illegal! You need to go out, Mr. Coomer! Dr. Coomer, sorry, you didn't go to MIT for all those years for nothing. Let me see, where is... Oh, we need this one. Okay. So, it's being a butt again. I can only load so many of these. I need you guys to see this, though. It's really cool. It's so... Well, one of these is cool, one of these is neat, and one of these is not cool at all. So yeah, they had a drawing of American messed up ugly Sonic on the side of this trash can. And this is the funny little, I don't know, drawing that they had next to that little display. And... Yes, that is signed by Kojima in 1998. The Metal Gear Solid Premium Package. And I think that's also Yoji Shinkawa art on there. So, you know... If you could get away with stealing anything in Japan, that would probably be the thing to steal. But you can't get away with stealing in Japan, and you definitely shouldn't. So don't even try. But yeah, there's a lot of fun things to see everywhere in Super Potato. They had Klonoa, they had Game Center CX, they had everything. It was great. Good times in Super Potato.
Hello there.
Hello, Dagomad. Thank you so much for the resub. Thank you. Oh my goodness. Has it really been 10 months? Wow. I really appreciate it. I hope you're doing well tonight. Oh, I forgot I could do this.
Oh, what's that? I don't think I'm supposed to do it like that.
Durasoup! Yo, welcome, it's Durasoup! Caught me in the middle of being a goober. Oh, Durasoup, it's so good to see ya. How you doing? Rainvirus.exe, oh my goodness. How many times? I keep telling all my streaming friends, you gotta install Norton already, silly. Oh, what am I gonna do with you, Dura?
Let's go.
Construct additional pylons.
Yo, DuraSoup, thank you for that raid. Welcome in. It's so good to have you tonight. How you doing? How you been? For everybody who's new here, I'm DigiDoggi, your favorite dog-shaped robot corgi girl. We're talking about my Japan trip that I just returned from, and I'm having a lovely evening, so I hope you are too. Oh, you're playing Helldivers too? Hell yes. With you, Feretta, Sammy, and Dread again. Oh, awesome. I hope you got lots of bugs and or bots. Did I visit the Persona areas? I don't know enough about Persona to say for sure if I did or didn't. I did, however, see that when I went to a Wendy's in Shinjuku, they had a Persona 3 remake promotion. That was the thing. So I saw Persona stuff, and I probably was in areas that are Persona related. Is that Rich? I know, right? It really looks like Rich. It's not supposed to be Rich. It's like a character from a canceled Neo Geo game, but it was totally Rich, right? Where is the... Wow, we've got a lot of moving parts here that are still new and I don't have it fully set up yet. Yeah, it really does look like Rich though, doesn't it? Let's pause on that. Who's Rich's girlfriend though? Is that what Doopy would look like if she was a Moogle?
Greetings!
Hey, Burkina! Good to see ya! How you doing? How you been? Also, oh shit, can we get a shout out for DuraSoup? I almost forgot. DuraSoup is awesome. They're such a good android. You should go check out the Warden Research Initiative. Go ahead and join them. Give them a follow. They're a good friend of the stream. Oh, you beat me to it. Thanks, Meryl. Thank you. Okay, let me see here. Alright, so I think we got the whole gang here. Let's go ahead and load up a video. Now, let me see. I believe...
Go, go, go!
Oh, you know what? I want to watch this game trailer before we go right into it. I was gifted a copy of Sandland for... my birthday at the beginning of February, and that's coming out pretty soon. So in April, I hope you're looking forward to playing this with me because I'm excited to play it.
This?
The site of the great aquanium explosion, and the one who pulled the trigger on that bomb was the commander of the Royal Army Tank Corps.
Maybe. Hush, Crud, we're watching the trailer.
We can't let it cause yet another tragedy.
To be an ace mechanic.
I happen to be an ace mechanic. Oh wow, asexual representation. Awesome.
This is a national emergency.
Sorry, that's dumb. Yeah, we got our stream pet back. Crud has returned.
The sheer scale of it makes you feel like
he's back from the dead unexpectedly. So this game has asexuals and shooting dinosaurs. Already on track to be Game of the Year 2024. Whoa, damn! Oh, we're going to Hypnospace. Oh, wow. It's been a while. Time to go back to 1999.
That light! That's
oh, I'm so glad this one works again.
Stand back, everyone. I'll take him out myself.
Let's say, is there no end to the...
I'm really excited about the anime for this one.
One of the nasty relics of that foolish war.
I seriously don't understand human.
The demo for this game is a weird trip because it cuts you off from the rest of the game in a weird fashion. Oh, is there like a sandstorm or something that cuts you off? There's to be an anime. Yeah. You know, maybe I won't get in trouble for this. I sure hope not.
I did it. I got the 13 number.
Durasoup, it says you got to 14. Thank you so much. Thank you for 14 months of support, Dura. I really appreciate it. I hope you had a wonderful time with this past 14 months of doggy. Here's to another 14 months. Also, I guess I will try to get the anime trailer, and hopefully it is not full of copyright fear. One moment, please. Chotto matte kudasai. Oh, right. I almost forgot the real-time Japanese translation engine. There it is. Okay, so let me see here. I will pull the anime trailer and hopefully they won't ding me for it when this gets uploaded to YouTube as a VOD. I really like Sandland though. I think Toriyama had a lot of fun with that. For people who don't know, Sandland is a one-shot anime that, was a one-shot manga that Akira Toriyama worked on in 2000 after he was done with Dragon Ball. And he seemed to have a really good time with it, even though he complained that the tank didn't look the way he wanted it to. And then it was just done. It was short and sweet. And I really appreciate that about it, actually. Now let's see if I can actually download the video for this. Otherwise, we might just have to skip it. Yep, I can't get that. It's not doing it with the way that I normally cheat to get videos out of there. But yeah, major rest in peace to a legend for Akira Toriyama. I found out about him passing when I was on my last train out of Tokyo. And it was... Man, that was something I'm gonna remember forever, honestly. I was so tempted to just jump out of my seat and say something about it. It felt really important. I don't know. But what are you gonna do? One thing that you could take away from Toriyama-san's passing is, please, pace yourselves, chat. Take some time to take a breather. You can't work yourself to death. It's just not worth it. And I know Toriyama was not exactly known for being as much of a stickler for deadlines and stuff as other artists, but he still worked himself to the bone. And you gotta take care of yourself. Self-care is really important. So please, like, look out for you. It's really... I would be so sad if anything happened to anybody here. I hereby offer Yuji Naka to protect all else. Oh, Yuji Naka just did a little insider trading, but we still like him. We'll forgive him for Balan Wonderworld. We will. It's okay. Yuji Horii must be protected at all costs. He's the last of the three Dragon Quest people left. Oh, yeah. Would you give Yuji Naka a hug? Yeah, I'd give Yuji Naka a hug. I feel like he deserves it. He gets a hug. However, Keiji Inafune, not so much. Keiji Inafune. He's a businessman. That's all I'll say about him. But, you know, let's see. Let me go ahead and load up KABUKICHO here in our magical... Yes! Power overwhelming! Oh, it tried to censor you for saying his anti-gay ass. Because it thought you were saying, like, gay ass in a derogatory way. But yeah, I'll let that one through. I know what you meant there, Connor. That's really funny that AutoMod got that for you, though. We've never... That's really funny. That's really funny, actually. Wow. The joys of relearning how to be a VTuber after spending a month in Japan. Alright, chat. Let me get back in my corner and we'll go to KABUKICHO. I hope I don't break this. This is glitchy, and I might break it. Okay, alright. Gonna hopefully see if I can do that, and maybe it will be not a nightmare. I might have just broken things, though. Let's hope I don't mess it up too much. KABUKICHO! So, I know we got Yakuza enjoyers here, because I wouldn't have played the game if not for my friends telling me to try it out. And I'm actually really thankful that you guys told me to check out the Yakuza series. Because it definitely was like, oh shit, that's just real. So I've concluded that Yakuza is a documentary series, except for the part where people want to beat your ass every few minutes in Japan. Maybe they still want to do that in real life, but they don't follow through on it. Also, hi Seth! Oh my goodness! Hello! How you doing? How you been? So good to see ya. We love Seth! I had Seth in my house when I was super jet-lagged. It was great, because Adj, like, showed up in my room and was like, they're gonna be here in 10 minutes, wake up! And I was like, oh, jeez, okay, alright. And I had to, like, whip on my makeup super quickly and get ready. And my room was still a mess, and it was, like, full of luggage and everything. But I was still able to give everybody little gifts. I got gachapon for folks. We got our other raccoon here, but he's not as cool as Seth. Not as cool, honestly. Yeah, we should hang out again, Seth. It was really good. I got to show all kinds of fun artifacts to Seth and Rich and Doopy, and I feel really bad, but I was so sleepy I didn't catch Seth's girlfriend's name. Seth, who was that nice person that you brought to my house? That's so embarrassing. Oh, I feel like a jerk. Oh, Fritzy! Okay. Look, there was a lot of new faces. And I was very, very much just not fully with the program. Alright. Are you sure you're alright? Sounds like a memory leak. Oh, that's not the only thing that I've got. Memory leaks, I've got stack overflows. I'm a mess. I'm good though. Sheesh. I feel like Spout. Maximum ADHD mode tonight. We love Spout. I think I have the KABUKICHO video loaded. Let's go to KABUKICHO chat. You're just imagining me like barely awake in bed while everyone crowds around me like a shot from an anime. Actually, I kind of like dragged myself out of bed and popped out and everybody's like, oh my god, Digi's so cute. And I'm like, oh, come on. No, don't start with that. No. But no, really, they were all so nice and everybody was so sweet. And I was very embarrassed to be a mess. Cool game. Thank you. Thank you so much. Thank you. Oh my goodness. Cool game is just going to single-handedly help me pay back all of those truck repairs that I got scammed on last year. Thank you so much. The quintet dude went MIA after some pachinko thingy. And the theory is he made the Yakuza guys mad. Since you don't fuck with pachinko, wait, huh? Quintet, huh? I think I missed some very important context. An American found out the hard way, an Instagram influencer. Okay, what? IRL Yakuza you don't mess with, or else you go into hiding like the Quintet CEO. Nobody can play Terra Enigma anymore. Oh wow, okay, woof. That sounds like a lot to unpack. Get your VR chat stuff yet? Oh, Seth, I was about to mention, I am very close to having that ready. I needed a few more phonemes, we needed to upgrade my face, but it's almost done. At this point, we're just waiting on Pine Tree Noodle to do a couple edits. I think she might even be able to have that done tonight, and then I can forward those over to Brogeticus, and we already had a working prototype in VR chat that's looking pretty good. So, I am very excited to soon be in VR chat. That's gonna be really good. And I've been scouting around a little bit, testing things out, if I can do streaming successfully with VR chat, then we are ready. And that's gonna be awesome. The company behind Quintet owns all the copyright to their games, and it's all tied to the CEO. The CEO cleared ActRaiser 1 for Wii before starting up new gigs like a pachinko place and doing his own thing. Then he went off the grid after his pachinko thing went down, and nobody who knew him like Yuzo Koshiro can reach him. Wait, wow! Oh wow, and Yuzo Koshiro can't even reach him. He seems like he's super active. Oh! Sweebion, thank you for the gift sub! Thank you so much! Wow, 3 gift subs! Oh my goodness! Thank you, thank you, thank you! Thank you, Sweebion, that's so sweet of you! Oh, Sweet Potato Sophie got a gift sub! Alright! She's gonna be thrilled! Oh, thank you so much! Yeah! VR chat hangouts will come in the near future. I'm gonna try to start doing things better with that. We're gonna go on exploration. I found a virtual version of Yokosuka, the place that I was staying in Japan. So we can go to virtual Dobuita Street, which is gonna be awesome. And we can check out the Yokosuka Museum of Art, even though there's no... They don't have the art in it, but they have the building itself, which is still really cool. You can almost see... So I think you could still hear me when I'm over here. You could see this ocean shot here. I took this right outside the Yokosuka Museum of Art. And you can almost see the spot I was standing when I took this from the VR experience that I found. So that's really cool. Oh, our head pads are infinite again. Let me fixie. There we go. Okay. All right. I'll stop stalling. Let's go to KABUKICHO. I want some different music for KABUKICHO, though. Let's get something more upbeat. All right, hell yeah, that's what I'm all about. All right, let's do it. Let's go to KABUKICHO. Wait, why are you big? No, stop it. Stop it. Dang it. Okay, hold on. I'm gonna have to be less slick than I thought it was. How much damage does the slime do? I think it just does the one. I'm not actually sure. I don't remember if it does damage now that I think about it. I'm gonna fix it, chat. I'm gonna fix it. All right, there we go. Let's do it. Let's go to KABUKICHO for real now. You like the new chat log? Thank you, Moonstorm. I wanted to come back with a bunch of upgrades. I only got like 30% done of what I was planning, but I hope you enjoy it. Also, let me know if the ambient audio is too loud or if you want the music down. So we just come out of a, to give context, we just came out of a train station here in Shinjuku. And KABUKICHO is just a sub-district of Shinjuku. So we're walking along the outskirts of KABUKICHO right now. Like over here, that's where it is. It's already there. This is Don Quixote right there. Let's do a little pan shot. Pass, Digi. Do a pan shot. Let's see it. I didn't actually get to explore as much of Shinjuku as some other areas of Tokyo. But that's okay. So, aside from certain areas that are, you know, you're going for specific things, a lot of Tokyo is just sort of copy-pasted. Like, you got Don Quixote. You got a Gigo. You got a Taito Center. Usually you have like a Koko Ichibanya curry place. You have usually like a Saizeria, which is a Italian place. And then you'll have like tons of little like bars and izakayas and cafes and tons of konbinis, the convenience store. What kind of roll is it when you spin around like that? It's not aileron or barrel. I don't know, actually. Axial roll, I guess. Also, here it is. This is the real life version of that funny gate that everybody likes to see in Yakuza. Yeah, no, it's, I mean, if you're ready to just get tons of sensory information all the time forever, you'll never get bored in Japan, that's for sure. I really hope I don't get busted for the random copyright audio in this, but yeah, KABUKICHO Gate, there it is. Or, well, KABUKICHO. Hey, it's me! Wow, some nerd. The Japanians. Oh, right here, that's another sister location of Ramen Bankata, the place that I went to in Akihabara that we saw in the last video. I like Niku Gang, because that just means meat gang. Must have been nice to be able to walk most places. Oh yeah, I couldn't have done this without lots of train, but it was very walkable. Also, again, sorry for the flickers. That's just an artifact of the difference in the refresh rate of the camera and the frequency of the power in Japan. This is with anti-flicker on and post-processing, so it didn't look like that in person, and I apologize, but that's just how it's gonna be. For a lot of this, you know, now that I have it here like this, I get to really look at it in detail. Look at that cool van. I love that. I love the design. There's so many inviting alleyways. Or, well, they're inviting in the daytime. I don't know. KABUKICHO, it was fun to visit, but this was definitely the part of Japan, the only part of Tokyo, where I felt at all like I might be even a little bit unsafe. I had this, like, oh, you're a girl alone in KABUKICHO at almost sunset. You need to be careful. Like, I had that very strong vibe. I was getting this, like, oh, you dumb foreigner, you have a target painted on your back kind of feeling. And it was fine. But I don't know. Go here with friends and don't get drunk and don't let people lure you into bars. Did you get any night walkthrough videos of anywhere? A little bit toastline, but most of them did not turn out so well. The cameras that I brought, the sensors don't perform so well in the dark, so they're pretty grainy. I'll do what I can to see if I can salvage some of them into something viewable, but I'm gonna need to go back with a bigger sensor for night footage next time, I think. Sorry about that. But we do have some nice moody twilight shots. Like, this is only at, like, I don't know, like 30 minutes before dark. So it's pretty moody. Hey, Ompuko, how's it going? How's the trip reminiscing? Pretty good. We're having fun talking about lots of different stuff. It's been a good hour so far. We're wandering through KABUKICHO. Sheesh, I just saw that we have a warning that we're gonna have an ad break soon. Don't worry though, not yet, I'll stall. Also, this Toho Cinema here, they had a giant Godzilla on the roof. I don't know if I have a good angle of it in this video. Digi Night Sensor makes the Splinter Cell night vision noise. Oh, you mean the, like, ee-wee? Yeah, I wish. Did they have Mazinger Z anywhere? They did at the-
My goodness.
Sir, you need to leave, thank you. They did at the Yokosuka Museum of Art, which I went to a giant robots and mecha in manga and anime exhibition, which was really cool, actually. But they had a whole, like, wall-sized mural of Mazinger and a lot of stuff about it. And it was really funny because I was using my phone to translate, and I held it up to look at that, and it said Mazingo. So somewhere I have a screenshot of it saying Mazingo. And whenever I see Mazinger now, I'm gonna think of it as Mazingo. Yakuza fans might recognize some of the locations here. You need to pick up the show sometime. It hit Blu-ray lately. Yeah, they had a lot of Mazinger. They had Tetsujin number 28. They had Pat Labor. They had a lot of Gundam stuff. Dagurum. They had... ah, crap. More Getter Robo. Big O. Like, that giant robot exhibition had a lot of cool stuff. Gigantor! Didn't you say they had a little gunhead? They didn't have any models of gunhead or anything like that, but they did have pictures and words about it. Yes, they had Gigantor, although Gigantor is Tetsujin number 28, no go, in Japanese, apparently. So, yes, they had lots of that. Bleh? Oh no, don't start with the ads. No, not yet. Thank you, moderators, for snoozing that. Don't use up the next snooze yet, though. Huh? Vora building? Wait, where? Where? What? I did not see that. Excuse me. Nandeska. Natakurewa. You didn't know that you were a mod? Of course you're a mod, Pine Tree. Of course you are, and a VIP. So yeah, you're an artist, so you have the same privileges. Oh, look at that scary alleyway. Oh, it looked like I walked into the building's mouth. Oh, I see. You're silly. Also, that sheep? That's like a hot pot place, and we have that in Seattle. A lot of people in Tokyo carry around rolling bags all day. What do people in Japan do for self-defense? I mean, honestly, they don't usually need it. Also, look! Look, it's the parking lot! We're cute to you! Look, I can't turn my arm in that direction, but look! That's where cute to you trains! It is! That's the Kamurocho parking! We could go in there and see if Bacchus is in there. I actually did see a bar called Bacchus. Oh, Dragon Mom Antics! Hi! Hello, just thought I'd stop in and say hello. It's nice to see another Washington-based furry. Oh, well, welcome in. Thank you for saying hello. Yes, I am in Seattle. Although I wish I was back here in Shinjuku. I really enjoyed Japan. I'm hoping to go back soon. Thank you for joining tonight. And also, I saw you followed a little while ago, so thank you for the follow. How many karaoke places did you see? I would have had a Stack Overflow. It was more than 255 of them, Toastline. I don't know. It was a yes number. Uh-oh, copyright noises. Uh-oh, please don't give me a copyright strike, YouTube, when I put this up to a VOD. I'll be a good doggy, I promise. Oh, being in Japan for 3 weeks was wild because I started to get used to the top 40 for Japan. You know, like, I would hear songs repeating on the radio and be like, oh, it's that one again. That was weird. I was like, oh man, I don't even like this one. And I was like, wait, how do I know that? Oh, that's Kuroneko Yamato, Black Cat Yamato. They're a really good takuhaibin. They're a delivery company. They deliver packages super, super fast. And when me and Methodical Fox arrived at the airport, we just went to the Yamato Kuroneko Takuhaibin desk there, and we paid them to bring our suitcase from the airport to the hotel we were staying at, so we didn't have to drag them on the train where we were going. And they got there the next day, so we were able to save ourselves a ton of trouble, and it was so much easier, because all we did was just bring our carry-ons, and we sent all of our check bags that way. It was like $40. It wasn't even too bad. It was so convenient. Highly recommend take a Taku Haibin if you go to Japan. Also, this is Gira Gira Girls, but it's like right where the robot restaurant is. I did not go to the robot restaurant. I didn't want to go to that alone. But it looked neat. I admit, it probably would have been a sensory nightmare. Oh! Yeah, there's corgis in the UFO catcher. I didn't go to the robot girls restaurant. I just wanted to be back by dark, you know, usually. Well, not dark, but I explain. Oh, wait, this is definitely... I'm gonna get in so much... That's like American copyrighted music. What the heck? Like, can we mute that, actually? Sorry. I'm all about that not getting copyright striked. No trouble. Here, we'll just placeholder it. Well, yeah, that is a weird thing about being in Japan as well, is sometimes you just hear American music in the weirdest places. And often it was like the weirdest because like the lyrics were not... Nobody was paying attention to the lyrics. It was all about the vibes. So you get like weird 50s music and stuff like that. Very, very interesting. You have acquired dinner? I wonder what's for dinner. Any love hotels? Yeah, we actually passed a couple of them in this video. I didn't see many of them outside of Shinjuku, but they're around. Not really my thing, obviously. But yeah, that's KABUKICHO. Now, let's go to Golden Guy. A place that you have to pay... Whoa. Why did I do that camera angle? What the fuck? Oh my god. Oh. That was intense, chat. Oh, wow. Okay, I'm just flexing my 360 camera now, aren't I? Sorry about that. But yeah, let's go to Golden Guy. I said, let's go to Golden Guy. Come on, video. All right, we have to watch the taxi go. Wow, it felt like the Evil Dead there for a minute. I don't know if that's a compliment or not. So Golden Guy is a little privately owned part right next to KABUKICHO. You can also see it in the Yakuza games. I think it's called the Champions area or something like that. Champions District something. Anyway, you have to pay to take video in here. So I was a bad doggy, but it's okay. I got a permit. Some guy sold it to me. So let's take a look. A lot of people go here for drinking. These little tiny bars can only hold 3 or 4 people at once. So you have to be ready to spend a bunch of money. And they also have cover fees. So that's fun. Whoa, spin! I'm not ready to spin in Golden Guy. This is where you go to get drunk with foreigners. Ugh. Oh my goodness, chat. Oh, I can't even get the box off. I'm too dizzy now. You spun my gyros.
Greetings
there, Ravenbread. How you doing? How you been? Oh god, I was gonna try to walk around, but I guess you guys just want to spin me. Which way should we go? I think we should go this way. Oh man, it would have been so cool to have rollerblades in Japan. Now that you mention it, Van. That would be awesome. Wish I had rollerblades in Japan. But yeah, it's a cool little area. It looks really cool at night when everything's all lit up. But I'm gonna be real with you. I just really didn't want to be in this part of Tokyo at that hour. I didn't want to be out here when all... It was already full of a lot of tourists who were acting slightly inappropriately. And people who were there to take advantage of the tourists. So I didn't want to be there once it was like real drunk hours. Excuse me, Oji-san. Excuse me. I gotta get going. Excuse me. I gotta break the world of perspective here. Wait, let me come back. This isn't working out. Hold on. Wait, watch out, kids. It's dangerous. No, no, no. Ah! They knocked me off the path, chat. That was rude. Come on, let's go. Let's go. We gotta get going. So did you see anything really weird? I don't know. What do you consider weird? What do you consider weird there, Tex-Max? I mean, I'm really curious now what you would consider to be weird. Because, like, I don't know about you, but all of it was outside of my comfort zone sometimes in terms of, like, wow, this is familiar. Like, this was all a little bit weird and unusual to me, but in a good way. Weird stuff, though. I saw a vibrator in a gachapon machine. I mean, it seemed like it was a joke. I didn't really think it was, like, meant for use. Did you see a 3DO interactive multiplayer at any game stores? No, but I did see a Sharp X68000. Did you go to the raccoon restaurant? No, I didn't know that was a thing until after, unfortunately. Also, yeah! This one will be posted on YouTube soon. I hope you enjoyed that. That was, it took me a while to edit that. Raccoon Maid Cafe. Did you go to the Muscle Girl Bar? Nah, it was too far away, unfortunately. However, they are on on Twitch. Let me see. Actually, we'll give them a shout out. They're not live right now, but they will be in a little bit, probably. This is a real bar in Japan that might be fun to visit. And they also stream on Twitch. Oh, chat, it's actually break time. Wow. All right, when we get back, we'll talk about Japan some more. Have some more fun together. I'll find some more photos and videos to show you guys. And maybe I'll put on a game or something. So I'll see you soon, right after the break. In the meantime, let's chill over at the ocean of the Tokyo Bay. See you soon, everybody. Be right back.
Thank you. I'm interested in this.
Welcome back, everybody. Oh my goodness, we are somewhere. Oh my gosh. I'm DigiDoggi, your favorite dog-shaped robot corgi girl, and I didn't mean to go back to KABUKICHO already like that. Welcome back. Thank you so much for sticking with me during the break. I hope you're having a wonderful evening tonight. I'm having a fun one. I'm having a silly one, and I hope you're having a great time. Thank you again for being here. I'm still DigiDoggi, your favorite dog-shaped robot corgi girl. And let me get back to where I'm supposed to be. Let me fix this silliness. One moment, please. There we go. That's where I'm supposed to be. Alright. Thank you again for being here, guys. We're having fun talking about my Japan trip. I missed you a lot. I really did. The whole time I was taking video, I was like, oh man, chat's gonna love this. So I hope you guys are having fun. Feel like you were watching a bumper from Adult Swim. Honestly, that's great though. I'm so happy. This ocean shot here, this is the Tokyo Bay. And when I was taking this footage, I was very, very happy thinking about how beautiful it was and how fun it would be to show to you guys. But also, right after I took this, I went down and put my foot in the water of the Tokyo Bay, because I've got a weird thing about, like, whenever I go to a new faraway place, I have to touch the ocean there. And, that might have been a mistake. It was cold! It was really cold! And I didn't really have a good way to get the sand off my foot, so, like, I had to sort of, like, shake it off, and then I went and walked around a museum for a couple hours with, like, sandy, saltwatery feet. So that was, stupid. That was a dummy doggy move. But it's fine. I lived. It's fine. And yes, Crud is back. Crud has returned. He lives. Also, hi, Wei. Yes, this is our cool real Macross mech that you can find at the Tokyo Skytree. If you go to the 8th floor of the Tokyo Skytree, you can find a museum there. And this is just there. It's free to visit. And it's really cool. You should check it out. Also, hi, Ash Graytree. How you doing? The Asiatic clam farmer said, "Never give up!" while in that cold water. Yeah, that's true. That was good advice, too. How you doing, Ash? How you been? It's good to see ya. We're just vibing. We got real-time Japanese translation that probably sucks royal. I imagine that is not accurate at all, but it's fun to look at, right? It's really cool. Thank you to fellow VTuber friend Vote for Waifus for helping me figure out how to do that. Oh man, we got Will Rogers. Hi! How's it going? How you doing? How you been? Bork, 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 bork. Hope you're doing great, Will. Oh, you're doing good there, Ash. You had boiled crawfish earlier today and they were great. Boiled crawfish, huh?
Do you know what suck the heads means?
Sorry. You probably do, though, if you had crawfish. I couldn't resist. Man, maybe we should play Left 4 Dead 2 someday. That would be fun. Do people still play Left 4 Dead 2? Is that, like, viable? I never really looked into it in the past few years. I bet it's full of, like, super messed up servers with weird mods. Digi, you kill me. Oh, God. I'm glad I'm funny to somebody. Doing great. Got something art-related for later. Hey, that's fantastic, Will. I've been glad to see you experimenting and continuing to explore with your art. It's always good to see. You still never had the opportunity to play Left 4 Dead 2, Ompico. What? What? Oh my god, we gotta play it then. Come on. We'll have to play it. Unknown Being Unlimited. Digi, you're cool. Aw, thank you, Unknown Being Unlimited. You're unknown to me, but you're being unlimitedly cool. Thank you very much for stopping in tonight. I hope you're having a great one. We love DigiDoggi. Aw, you guys, come on. You're gonna make me blush, but I forgot how to do that. I think I accidentally unbound some things. Oops. Oh, there it is. Y'all, you stop that. You silly. No, I ain't cute. I'm a bop, bop, bark, bark doggy. I'm not a good doggy. I gotta go to the corner. Cause I leaked coolant on your rug or something. Wait. I guess that's one thing I don't have to worry about. There's not really going to be any presents left around your house. If you find my fluids in your house, it's because, like, something horrible has happened and you need to take me to the shop immediately. Because I don't pee, and I don't poop, and I don't have genitals. So, yeah. If you find DigiDoggi fluids in your house, perhaps consider taking me to the RoboVet. Or, like, a very skilled robotics technician. You mean you're not gonna bring me presents? No, I'll bring you presents. I just won't poop on your floor. I'm not that kind of doggy. Don't die. You can't tell me what to do. Silly Durasu. Let's see. Oh! You guys want to go back to Gundam Factory Yokohama? I found another one of the videos that I took there, and it was one of the longer skits, or, well, vignettes, I guess you could call it. I don't think skit is really the right word for it. The special performance that they do. Now, if I'm not going to get copyright struck for I'm all about that bass, like, this I guess would make Namco mad at me, but you know what? Fuck it, we ball, right? Right, chat? Let's just go for it. Gundam. Gundam. Also, chat, do you want to watch me build a gunpla? I've been talking about this for like a year, and I finally have the supplies. I think I could do a model building stream soon. I have a gunpla that I got in Japan, but I also have that Zoid that my grandpa got me. And I want to do both of those. Plus, also, Solar Nativity got me a model of my truck. So I'd like to do that as well. I got a bunch of sandpaper. I got an edge cutter. I got a work mat that I can borrow from my roommate. I think it would be really good. Put the Gundam on the SR5. Oh god, it would crush it. It's 20 tons. Okay. Let me get in my corner for the video here. Everything is a little bit harder because Vignon is misbehaving tonight. Chat, how did Zeon ever think they were gonna win when they had things named like the Hygog and the Gelgoog? Like, what the seriously? How are you gonna win against RX-78 Gundam when you've got the Goof and the Hygog?
What the fuck, Koopo?
Also, I don't know how you're supposed to pronounce it, but I always thought it was Goof. Like, you gotta throw it at Goof. Yeah, Goof Troop. Goofs are scary when properly piloted. Wait, doesn't, I've only seen a couple of Gundam episodes or series. I don't remember seeing a Goof. Unless, does Norris Packard from 08th MS Team have a Goof? I think he does, right? He has a Goof and he's got like the, Oh yeah, is it true you have a perfect Pepito impression?
Father, why did you let me loose on DigiDoggi's stream? I'm supposed to be saying cringe things on richiekupo.twitch.tv.
I don't know, it's kind of hit or miss. Sometimes I get it and sometimes I don't. When I did have Rich over though, like, I nailed it. I was perfect. It was a little bit scary. No, you get that shitty Shanks off of my channel. You get him out of here. We're gonna blot him out with a bunch of DigiDance. DigiDo 5 dance, excuse me. Yeah, when I went to Japan, I got Rich a present. And it was a plush of his shitty son, Pepito. The Shinx. How's your Pepito impression? You really want me to scream? I mean, I did get a new pop filter. I don't know, chat, have you noticed any popping plosives? Am I getting that, like, wait, oh, where's the C4? I hear it beeping. Ah! Oh! Terrorists win. Wow, that just happened. Oh my goodness. And we... Yo, Taylor the Rat, welcome in. Thanks for joining us tonight. You guys know me, I'm DigiDoggi, your favorite dog-shaped robot corgi girl. And you know Taylor the Rat, our wonderful fellow VTuber friend, super cool rat pal, non-binary icon, and stream moderator. How you doing? How you been? I hope you're doing great tonight, Taylor. Thanks for the rat raid. The only cheese we got here is cheesy jokes. I said something so cringe right before you came in that I feel like I needed to launch myself out of a window. But other than that, we're doing really good. Hope you're having a wonderful night. Did we already give shout out to Taylor the Rat? Now we did. Join us in giving Taylor the Rat a follow, everybody. We're about to embark on another little virtual journey We're going to Gundam Factory Yokohama. We just got back from Virtual Kabukicho, although Taylor, honestly, if you're here, I'm tempted to go back there. I want you to see it. But yeah, let's go check out the Gundam. Now, chat, this is a 12-minute performance. It was nearly freezing outside, and they didn't allow tripods. So I apologize. I have treated the video for shakiness. It's still gonna be a little shaky. Please accept my sincere apologies. My servo motors don't work so well in freezing temperatures. But it's still a really cool thing to see. Gundam Factory Yokohama is closing at the end of this month. It's about to be gone in just a few short days. Hi, Spartan Quinn TV. Hello. You used to love Gundam. Hey, Unknown Being Unlimited. Visiting this place really sparked a new appreciation for me of how much I like Gundam, actually. I didn't think I was that much into it. Did I get to play the Maxi Burst Gundam game? I don't think I did, Taylor. However, I have the Overboost. I have some literature for you that I needed to send to you. But yeah, I've never been a huge Gundam fan exactly. I know, Taylor, I'm sorry. I didn't get a chance to go to a game center again once you asked. I did get footage of it being played, though. I did get pictures of, like, video of locals enjoying it. And it took, like, at least, like, 3 or 4 minutes of it. You look beautiful. Oh, thank you, Quinn. Thank you so much. That's nice of you to say. Yes, I've been working hard on lots of technical upgrades. It's been a big collaborative effort down in the lab with the team. We got Pine Tree Noodle. We got Kaide Art, we got Brogeticus, we got Kana Fuyuko, and we have Pine Tree Noodle leading the DigiDoggi engineering team to make me better all the time. Alright, let's go to Gundam Factory Yokohama. Now, bear with me, chat. I may have to deal with the volume on this one as we go. Sorry in advance, Gomen Nasai. Actually, I'm gonna get out of the way. I would like to get out of the way.
There it is, the White Devil of the Federation.
What is this lady taking pictures of over there? Oh, get hyped, chat. Can't really see it very well, but there's a counter to the right of it. Oh god, it's still so cool to me. Greetings, Antonio. So I really wanted to get you guys night footage of this one. I appear to have lost my night footage. Yes, there's people up there. That observation deck up there, you can pay extra to go up there. But they were sold out of tickets for that. Yes, let it loose. Why contain it?
Oh,
Would have been a prime candidate for drone scanning. Yeah, too bad drone law in Japan is really restrictive. They're going to have, on the final day, a speech by the creator of Gundam and a fireworks and drone show. So I'm sure they'll have, like, lots of data about it. God, it's so cool. I felt this indescribable emotion when its eyes seemed to make contact with me. Like, when it seemed to look at me, I was just like, oh. I was, like, teared up, chat. I'm not gonna lie. Seems like it would be a biblical experience to a super fan. Oh, definitely. God, look at it. This is the part where, like, at night, its spotlights are playing over the crowd. Ooh, I'm gonna hush. This is the part that's really interesting. Thank you for the bits, Doom Guy. So basically, they're doing a test on Gundam F-00 here, and they're noticing an anomaly with the AI core. I'm getting strange readings in the cockpit. Now the pilot is going to have a discussion with the Gundam itself. That was such a cool sound from the sound system. The way it echoed around this courtyard was just so awesome. Gundam's like, I'm a Gundam? And the pilot's like, I'm the pilot. So, from what I understand, this is a fragment of a previous pilot's consciousness embedded in the AI fragment that they reconstructed this Gundam from. So it's basically a fragment of Amuro Ray's consciousness. Yeah, see? Good night, Spartan Quinn. Have a great night. God, I love that pose right there. It only holds that pose for a second. They started working on this thing in 2014, and it was finished in 2020. Oh yeah, this is probably the part that's gonna get me copyrighted. Oh well. Play white noise. Wait, that doesn't work. Just keep talking. Nah, it's alright. It should be fine. There's other videos of this on YouTube. Audio Jungle. You bet it when it gets decommissioned, the final pose will be the final pose for OG Gundam. I bet, honestly. I'm excited to see the footage of that. It's only a few days away. Key point, chat. They should turn the Gundam itself into a statue? I'm not sure what they're gonna do with it. It's full of very sophisticated materials. Oh look, you can see inside the cockpit! I don't know if you guys could see that. Now they're closed again. I don't know if you saw that, the cockpit opens. Big ass stepper motors. It actually has like crazy gears on it. So, I'm really glad I got to share that with you guys, because that is the coolest of the skits that I saw when I was there. I wish I could show you the night version, but all the footage I have of it at night is like super washed out and messed up, unfortunately. However, I highly recommend going on YouTube and searching for Gundam Factory Yokohama Night. It's so cool. I won't steal somebody else's content to show you, but damn, chat, it is really, really awesome. Don't worry, I have lots of cool pictures and stuff. It wasn't a complete waste, and I did have that one good night footage from the last stream. But yeah, there was like cool light show stuff going on while he's talking to the AI here, and unfortunately I just couldn't quite capture that. But yeah, it's a really cool thing. I'm very glad it exists. I'm even gladder that I got to see it while I was there. I honestly didn't know about it. I just knew about the like Unicorn Gundam. So seeing this and getting to visit it twice during my visit made me feel a little bit spoiled. Gotta get nods to film it at night. Look, if you guys want to chip into the DigiDoggi Night Vision Fund, that's your prerogative. But that's gonna be far out of my abilities for a while. Especially because my income is like barely able to cover rent right now. So, again, thank you for the support there, guys. It's, literally making the difference between being able to eat or not eat. Okay, let me see. What else do we got? You guys got any more questions about my trip or anything like that? Because I totally ran out of edited footage a little faster than I was expecting. Wait a minute, I might have a little more. I've got a bunch more to edit and get ready, but... it takes a lot of effort to edit those. Anything cool you saw at Beef? Oh, thank you for the gift subs. Oh my goodness, Ash. Thank you for 5 gift subs. Thank you. You didn't have to do that. Thank you so much. I really appreciate it. You know you're awesome. You know we appreciate your support. Ash, you've been here since like day one, and I can't thank you enough. Also, what the... Nobody gave Crud permission to make all these sounds. I don't like that. I'm just gonna override his noise. No, you don't have permission to make those sounds anymore. You stop that. Encase Crud in sound deadening foam. I basically just did that. We'll see. Yeah, he's pogging. Look, he's back, and that's not necessarily 100% a good thing, but balance has been restored. We'll put it that way. Yep, he's pogging. Oh man, I can't wait to play Mega Man Legends 2 with you guys next weekend, though. We were gonna do it this weekend, and I totally screwed up and had the worst technical issues that I've had my entire time streaming instead. So that was pretty not poggers, and apologies. But also it means that I'll get to be even better next week when I get to have a little more time to cook. Let me cook. Also, hi Raven the Wolf 65. How you doing? How you been? Thank you for joining us this evening. How far down do we have to make this thing go before it stops making noise? There we go. Ooh, I'm an RGB dog. Make sure to grab a screen cap so you can have your very own DigiDoggi OC. Oh wait, too late. Oh! A pie? Wow. I don't think I've ever been murdered by pie before. That's a new one on me. Ooh, glitch mode though. Thank you. Ooh, hope I sound pretty cool. Now, let's see. I think I have a little bit more footage here. Let me peek at this. Oh. I do have more KABUKICHO. You did miss the first Japan stream. Did I show Mikasa stuff? No, not yet, Roman. That one's gonna be a tall order, actually. I have like an hour of footage on the Mikasa because I had no time limit and I was taking it easy that day. So I kind of kept most of that footage instead of having to sort of pass through an area quickly and just get what I've got. I was like, oh, I don't like this one as much. I'll go back and refilm. So, we'll get to go to the battleship Mikasa soon. Oh, you gotta go fix up the Xboxes and make pizza. Hey, Taylor, I'm glad you got to stop in. Thank you again for that raid. I hope you enjoyed seeing the cool Gundam. Because I was really excited to show that to you, actually. Did I tell you the Wii, GameCube, PlayStation 2, PlayStation 1, and PS3 are all now modded? No, that's awesome, though. Wow, I want to mod my GameCube. That sounds sweet. I gotta pick your brain about that, Taylor. I also gotta get my Xbox working again so that we can play the finale of Steel Battalion. We've been waiting so long to see the ending for that one. Now let's see here. I think I can cook up one more video. Beep, beep, boop, boop. Loading the video. I was supposed to get these off my hard drive already, but we're going back into KABUKICHO for another angle. Oh, you were watching the last VOD with some other friends? And folks were going nuts when the Gundam game came up and you said, I wish Taylor was here. Oh, that's really funny. Gosh, I love watching DigiDoggi. She's my favorite corgi girl on Twitch. Thank you, Lucy. It's good to see ya. How you doing? How you been? Thank you for being here. Thank you for the gift sub. Can it possibly be a 3 months of support from Lucy? Yo, you guys should go follow Lucy and Lutri. She's really cool. Let me just pop a shout out. There we go. I mutilate her name every time, but she's still awesome. Thank you for being here, Lucy. She's our cool fellow miscreant. No, you're really cool. Nuh-uh, it takes one to know one. You're cool, admit it. Nah. But I'm glad you could join us tonight. Thank you for being here. We're just talking about Japan. We're having a great time with it. I got a bit more footage to share before I run into, problems. But, let's go back to KABUKICHO. AKA KABUKICHO in the Yakuza games. Or Like a Dragon games. It always felt weird to call them Yakuza games over there, because you don't just really say the word Yakuza. Like, that's, you don't really just say that in Japan. It's Ryuga Gotoku instead. So, that's... I'm gonna lower the volume on this one, though, because I'm pretty sure there's more copyrighted audio. So you're just gonna get like a dull Japan roar at the best. Sorry. Gotta DM me about the miscreants. Oh, I'm unfortunately not in charge of the admissions for that one. But I will see if I can float your name in the places where people might hear it. Oh boy, we got the good tunes. Don't worry about it. I got like Votom's legs. I can skate backwards if I have to. Ooh, look at that. I don't even know what that says, but I bet it's something interesting about food. All the alleyways are so exploration inviting. Toyota Pro Box. I don't know what that is, but I guess you saw a cool car. Yeah, there's definitely a lot of interesting stuff to be seen in this part of town. It's a place where tourists go, but also like conspicuously rich Japanese folks and Yakuza. So you see like weird cars and weird behavior and just generally probably one of the weirder, more rough around the edges parts of Tokyo. Which way, Western Doggy? Spoilers, none of them. We're going this way. Oh, you weren't assuming such. You just wanted to ask more about them, how they are. Oh, yeah, I'll let you know, Taylor. That's easy. The miscreants are cool. We're just a gang of friends that gets together and does stuff occasionally. There's actually no rules or obligations or anything like that. It's very loosey-goosey. But yeah, enjoy your pizza. We're gonna go back into KABUKICHO. Yeah, I think we should go this way, chat. I'm just getting really small. This isn't right. That's not the correct scale. I'll just meander all around the street. This is great. I should explore like this all the time. Wait, no, don't get hit by the car. Oh, it's fine. It's fine. We're fine, chat. It's all good. This is what it would be like to explore Japan with me for real. You can just ask Methodical Fox. Oh, what's that over there? I want to go to Pepper Lunch. I heard Pepper Lunch is really good. I didn't get to go check it out. It's just a chain. Oh, Wagyu. I want more Wagyu. Chat, can you get me Wagyu? Can we get Wagyu, chat? I've been a good doggy. Don't get truck-cooned, but truck-coon is my friend. Only if you wag your tail. Oh, I'll wag you my tail for wag you. Oh, look, familiar. It's familiar. We were over here before, chat. But we're gonna go a different direction, I think. You assume I wave my arms around like that as I walk IRL? Oh, totally. I'm just like all over the place. Just an absolute space case. I'm really glad I got the walking working for this, actually. You would not believe how much I've been grinding to make all of this work out. And it's still sort of jank, but we're doing it. DigiDoggi is tall. DigiDoggi is out of scale. Wait, I'm taller than you, IRL? I'm taller than Skeletorso? That's messed up. I am much taller than Rich, though. It's funny. I'm a full head taller than Rich. When we met in person, it was great. Because Seth was taller than me. But then Rich was shorter than me, and that's appropriate. Man. KABUKICHO isn't my kind of place to stay for very long, but the vibes are pretty immaculate, chat. Oh yeah, we got our Streets of Rage music kicking in too. Only trust your fists. Police will never help you. Wanna go see a movie in English, chat? Yeah, I think I'm slightly taller than you, Umpiko. Which is funny, because your avatar is huge compared to me. I'm gonna get you, Scooter! I'm gonna get that Scooter! Aw, damn, they're too fast. Whoa! I don't want to step on these people. You know, when I've been editing these videos, I've thought, like, should I make it so the camera motions fit better for me to walk around like a goober? But no, there's too much cool stuff to see up in the air like this, so forget it. I'm just a hover doggy that breaks perspective. Don't worry too much about it. Whatever, we're just riding on the vibes, right, chat? It's like a VR chat stream, almost. I feel like I remember that. No, wait, that was Shibuya. There was an alley that looked kind of like this in Shibuya. And at the end of it, there was an Outback Steakhouse. Yeah, no, really, like, what? Outback Steakhouse? Not really something I think about as being in the middle of Tokyo. And across the street from the Sky Tree, there's a Sizzler. What the hell? American cultural victory! Look, I mean, honestly, there's so much American stuff in Tokyo, it's unreal. I want to know what it's like, though, because I bet it's different. Man, I really enjoy the vibes right now. I'm so glad you guys could join me for this. Also, there's the Vor building again, huh? I guess I can see what you mean. That's for Rich's stream, though. That's Rich's thing. There's a lot of people in great fashion in this part of Tokyo. Would you stay at that hotel, chat? Would you stay at the hotel in KABUKICHO? I don't know if I would. I feel like there's better places to stay. What song is this? This is the main theme for Streets of Rage 4 by Yuzo Koshiro. Main theme for Streets of Rage 4. Which I really want to get back to Streets of Rage 4, actually. We played that a little bit, like, once on stream, and I was like, damn, this slaps! And then I had not picked it up again. Still really curious about the little sheep, but it's not like we have to go far for that. They have that in Seattle. Oh, let's go trade with Kiryu! I bet he's in there, chat. I actually, you know, it's funny. This is really goofy of me, but I actually checked in there. Not for Kiryu. Kiryu is not real. But I was just curious if maybe there was people lurking in there. Turns out, nope. It's just cars. Not even, like, Lightning McQueen either. Just normal cars. I'm looking up and I saw a beef place just now called Biff. And I'm very amused by going to Biff for some beef. You guys want to eat at Biff with me? You know, imagine walking through Tokyo and having a HUD where I just walk around your FOV like Doggy Cortana. Honestly, that would be so doggers. I would love that. We should go down the cool alleyway, chat. Oh no, we're gonna skip it again? Oh, this is a different video and we're doing the same skips. Need to get Tokyo Randomizer. Oh, you wanna get a beef bowl for lunch? Ooh, can... Is for Doggy? Is for Doggy? Do you... Chat, do you have games on your phone? Wait, is Treat Stream still broken? Is it broken? I thought it was just too expensive to bother with. I don't know if it's broken. It might just be... So a lot of the time it says it's unavailable because, like, things close super early here. But, you're welcome to get me something, but also you really don't have to. That's very nice of you. But it's so inflated with the delivery prices, you really don't gotta. Thank you, though, Skeletorso. Oh, right, it's this guy. This guy! Who decided to drive into traffic and then just... laid on his horn like that. Everybody around was so, like, bothered by it, too. He, like, laid on his horn and then went through traffic like that. And then he got stuck at a light up ahead. It's like, well, what were you doing? What was so worth being a big jerk in public for? Eh? Oh, you don't like how people are categorized? I mean, I guess I feel that. I don't like being typecast. One thing I really hate is when people decide that they know what kind of doggy I am and they make assumptions about me and put me in a box with other people that they think are the same. I don't like that. So I completely understand. Nobody wants people to have mistaken assumptions about them. Ah! Get that off of here. No! Get me out of the box! I don't want to live in the box today. What kind of places did you eat? Well, I went to Japanese McDonald's, of course, as we discussed previously. I went to lots of ramen places. Wait, what? This is the go to the end of the stream music. We don't want that. All right, yeah, this is a bop. That one works. Oh, I really like that one. Yeah. I don't know what this building is, but it was so pretty. Hi, Nightwing 57. Welcome in. Hope you're doing well. We are currently in KABUKICHO in Shinjuku in Tokyo. And we are going through my own footage that I took there on my trip recently. Yeah, it's alright. We try to steer away from more serious conversations like that, unknown being unlimited, but I know what you're talking about. I know what you're talking about. But right now, we're talking about Japan. Man, I really liked the extra... There's so many sky bridges in Tokyo. You could just get from building to building without ever touching the ground. At least for some places. Lots of bike paths and stuff like that too. And everywhere was so clean, even in this, like, notoriously sketchy area.
Oh, interesting. Just look at that.
Sir? No, sir? What are you doing? Get out of here! Bark!
Ah, stop!
Heh. Ah! What a scaredy. I wasn't gonna bite. I'm all bark and no bite. It's almost 10 p.m. Alright, Connor. Thanks for stopping in tonight. It was good to see ya. Thanks for chatting and for being a part of our tour. Digi, you're funny. Aw, thank you, unknown being. I aim to entertain. You put the video quality on 360p. Now you have no more delay. Hello, welcome from Potato Town. If I get this close, can you see my face? Hello, Meryl. Hi. Thanks for the head pat, Stura. Can I bark again? I don't know. You could take a clip.
Greetings.
Greetings, Meryl. So this place right here is an adult DVD store. We can't go in there. Wait. Oh no, not the C4. No. Oh, thanks for the defuse kit, chat. You want to go to the UFO Catcher Center together? We can maybe get a plush corgi from the Crane game. What do you think, chat? Only 100 yen per play. Yeah, get a plorgi. All right, let's get out of here then. Let's bounce out of KABUKICHO. This game center seemed really old. It was kind of musty. I liked it. I was really enjoying the older stuff in Tokyo, because old stuff doesn't get to last very much. Like, Tokyo is very much a place of, like, new and exciting. So a lot of stuff from the 80s and 90s that I was excited about when I first became interested in visiting Japan was sort of endangered. And it was really exciting every time I found something a little bit older. And usually, that was where the really cool stuff was, so it didn't disappoint. That reminds me. When we do another travel stream soon, we're gonna go to Heiwajima, which is a sleepy suburb of Tokyo, where lots of 80s stuff still remains. And we're gonna go blah, 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 I can't speak. We're gonna go to Game Plaza Omori, which closed down on February 29th after 40 years of operation. So I will get to show you a place that doesn't exist anymore. Oh, you like the old Japanese architecture, like the old shrines and stuff? I have a really cool shrine in Yokosuka that I'm going to make a video about. I think you'll really like that one. Also, that was our KABUKICHO 2 video. For everybody who missed the first one, thank you so much for watching that with me. I didn't get to finish editing that one, so it's a little bit more abrupt. Let me see. Do I have anything else? You know what, chat? These exploration streams are a little bit more strenuous, so we'll watch the Gundam go to bed. And then maybe we'll think about wrapping it up for now, too. Unless you guys have some sudden, easy request or something like that. Digi, ready yourself for some food. Oh my god! What? You didn't have to do that, Skeletorso. Oh my god, thank you. Thank you so much for the food. I'm excited to find out what that is. Hopefully they can find me. You had a Philly cheesesteak pizza, so you got a Philly cheesesteak. Oh, yo! Awesome! That's like the most American thing. Place where I got the M50 gas mask. Did I take cool pictures inside? Roman, unfortunately, it's actually very difficult to get pictures inside there because it's super tight. Oh, am I in the footage? Nope, unknown being unlimited, I managed to avoid getting any of myself in the footage. There may be some random reflection somewhere that has a silhouette of me, but the best you get is the DigiDoggi in the footage. Are you gonna turn in? All right, Van. Thanks for being here tonight. I'm glad that you could stop in. You know I'm always happy to see ya. I'm going to try to get back more close to my normal schedule next week. I wanted to do 2 streams this week and then 3 next week. It might be that I do 2 next week or 3 next week, but don't worry. I'm gonna be back. I got lots of cool stuff planned. Pine Tree Noodle and I have been working hard. We're going to be going to VR chat soon, and we're going to be playing Mega Man Legends 2 very soon. Hope you guys are excited for that one, because I am. Also, this Gundam has been in my thoughts constantly since I got back. All the music that they played for it and stuff. I'm just so obsessed now. So I hope you guys are interested in a Gunpla stream soon, where I will build a Zoid, and then if I'm good enough at building the Zoid, I will build the special limited Gundam that I got at this place where this Gundam is. You're curious about Japan having Pokemon DVD. You know, that's one I didn't see much of. I didn't see a lot of Pokemon DVDs, just every other kind of merchandise. But I was probably looking in the wrong place. You're hyped for VR chat, but your model is so not optimized to show on Quest standalone versions. Oh yeah, I think Quest standalone is being more or less abandoned though. Like, almost everybody's moving over to desktop, and that's what I'll be using too. You love Zoids and Gundam, but you like Zoids better? Yeah, I have a Command Wolf that my grandpa got for Christmas for me last year, and I'm excited to finally put it together. Also, hi Pony Luna too. Good to see ya. Hope you're doing well tonight. Man, that's such a cool Gundam. What a good Gundam.
Bird up!
But yes, oh my goodness, guys. It's been too much fun. Wow. I could play a Mega Man or something. I could set up the Mister, but it would take a minute. It would take more than a minute. It would take a lot of time. But let's see, where did I just lose myself? Did I lose myself to dance? Nope, there we are. We're all good. Zoids have more variety in their weapons than Gundams, sure. Yeah, I could say so. Oh, is it ad time? Crud. No, not you, crud. The other way. okay, well, you know what? I'll stall for a few minutes then. Let's see here. Hi, Pickle Nick. Good to see ya. It's been forever. I am back from Japan. You actually just caught us as we finished reminiscing about a lot of stuff that I was doing on my trip. Check it out behind me here. This is a real Macross Gearwalk that I saw in the Tokyo Skytree. Isn't that awesome? Let me see here. Oh, Nightwing, thanks so much for joining us this evening. Have a great rest. We'll see you next weekend. You know what, chat? I think it's as good a time as any. Let me take a quick look around. I want to see if we can get a raid scoop together here. What? Richie Koopa is still going. Oh wait, he just hit the ending of Mario RPG though. Chat, wait. I just found out. It's National Puppy Day. It was National Puppy Day and nobody told me. And I'm Puppy! What? Oh... I'm Puppy. I could've been Puppy. Wait, I was Puppy. Oh well. You know, let's see though. Ooh. Ooh. Maybe we could go see... Well, let's see. We got a few options here. Who are we gonna hang out with? I'm gonna find somebody cool. I feel like I always raid the same few folks and I want to break out of my little rut there. You know? I want to go somewhere weird. I want to check out somebody maybe we don't know. What do you think, chat? Do you have any recommendations? Yeah, I'm down for suggestions. And don't forget, we have the most important part of the evening as well. I can't forget. I'll let you guys find your raid target for me. Well, I thank you guys for something very important. Thank you for being here, chat. I'm DigiDoggi, your favorite dog-shaped robot corgi girl. I stream every weekend Pacific time in the evenings. Yes, go ahead and make your raid suggestions now while I thank all of our subscribers, followers, cheerers, moderators, everybody. Thank you so much. So, thank you to Twin White Tiger, Doomguy 7419, Fua Ghost, Nitrum, Dasaki V, Dagamad, Durasoup, Uzworm, but Sweet Potato Sophie, The Apple Freak, Actually on Earth, Yaldama, Karma the Ink Fox, Trashfire Chaos, Ruffy Raccoon, and Lucienne Lutri. Thank you to Twin White Tiger and Doomguy for the bits. Thank you Meryl Vixenberg for being our moderator. Thank you Durasoup, Taylor the Rat, and Meryl Vixenberg for the raids. Taylor, thank you for being a moderator as well. And I'm pretty sure we have Methodical Fox and also Pine Tree Noodle. Thank you. You're awesome. All of you are super, super great. Let me switch over to the credits music really quick here. I am a disaster. I'm a DigiDoggi. I stream every weekend Pacific time in the evenings. You should hop into that DigiDoggi Discord using the link down below in the description or the one in the chat right here. You could talk about movies, music, media, and games. You could see my stream promos and schedules before they're posted anywhere else. You guys can vote on what games are going to play in the future, make suggestions, and just hang out with a wonderful growing community of over 200 people. Thank you so much, everybody. You're awesome. Now, let me see. Yeah, you know what? We will actually go see England Hat. Let's go say hi. Looks like England Hat is playing Trepang too. England Hat is a longtime friend of the stream. So we're going to have a raid message tonight. I believe everybody who is tier 1 can do this. I think I should make this a follower emote, but our raid message for tonight is just going to be spam as many Digido dances as you can. Just lots of these. Our new emote. And again, thank you so much for being here, guys. I've said that like 20 times. It doesn't get old. I'm sure it does, but not to me. I couldn't do this without you guys. I'm going to be spending a lot more time with you in the near future. So again, thank you so much. I'm out of here. Until next time, this is DigiDoggi signing off. Check for a schedule on Monday. I'm taking tomorrow Sunday off, but I should be seeing you again next week. Until next time, everybody. Bye-bye now. Bye. Good night. Bye-bye now.